When I think of a near-perfect movie that not only has stood the test of time, but on a structural level, is far more polished and clever than it gets credit for, one of the first that comes to mind is the 1990 Ron Underwood-directed Tremors.
Be advised, however, there are two more mother humpers.
Easily, one of the best monster movies to ever get made, Tremors boasts the trifecta of genre movie making. A tightly paced and smart script. A great cast of character actors, making even the most one-dimensional parts stick out. And of course, unique and cool practical effects. So today, let's head back to perfection and explore the dangers of what lies beneath the Nevada desert. This, my friends, is Tremors.
Nice hearing from you, Carlos.
With somewhat of an underwhelming box office performance, debuting at number 5, Tremors, like Shawshank years later, found a second life in the aisles of the video store. Not to mention, it was on TBS, among other channels, every week for like my entire childhood. And that's why I'm here today. Tremors is a near masterpiece, and all this is because of the direction from Ron Underwood and screenplay by Brent Maddock and S.S. Wilson. A genre mixer made of a charming small-town comedy and a western horror creature feature. See, Tremors walks a fine line and never wavers. This is a textbook example of knowing what you got and exactly where you are going. Tremors works because it's the epitome of a story with no fat on the bone. Opening shot, great matte painting by the way, establishes the open rural setting and the lifestyle of Val and Earl live. Just watching Val search for a smoke through empty pack after empty pack lets you know exactly who he is. And of course, him constantly missing the nail for the barbed wire gives you kind of the quality of work they do. Brent Maddock and S.S. Wilson carve out a world where everything has a purpose and nothing is left to chance. But the most surprising thing is the tone that brings a sweetness to the eventual mayhem and how organic it feels. A quick journey down IMDb shows you why. They're responsible for the great short circuit and batteries not included. Even f***ing Ghost Dad. Now listen, I'm not saying that Ghost Dad is good, but, well, you know, a younger and more, stoned me, I got a little enjoyment out of it.
Put the bitch on the phone!
Everything here is slyly set up. The cat in the trailer in the background, Mindy's love for the pogo stick, Chang's faulty cooler, or even Bert's prepper attitude. Nothing is wasted, nothing is for the sake of plot convenience. There's a saying, keep it simple, stupid. And it's a guiding principle co-opted for writing, and Tremors does this with perfection. Things move at a fast but reasonable pace, setting up the characters in town, then the monsters, and eventually the predicament of escape, all within an hour and 36 minutes. Listen, this baby ain't wasting time, and we are better for it. What works in tandem with such a well-rounded script is the cast that brings the small town of perfection to life. There isn't a single wasted character. Nobody here could be excised without a domino effect. Everybody serves a purpose, and as rare as it is, shines through making each role their own. Tony Gennaro's Miguel feels like a true salt-of-the-earth rancher, and his little interactions have a sense of sort of kindness and belonging.
They wasn't making no noise. Why is he bothering them for?
Of course, Michael Gross steals the show as the paranoid gun guy, but what I've always liked is that even if they kind of lightly use his paranoia for a bit of a laugh, they never make him out to be the goofy gun nut. Bert is fleshed out, caring and wise.
Broke into the wrong goddamn rec room, didn't you, you bastard?
I mean, hell, he even checks Melvin's gun once he gets it back, which he knew wasn't loaded because he follows the main rule of handling a gun. Always assume it's loaded once you take your eyes off of it.
All guns are always loaded.
Finn Carter's Rhonda has the sweet and innocent charm and holds her own against Bacon and Ward, which should be noted. I mean, Carter is an important piece here, and she gives Rhonda a lot of heart.
We run like goddamn bastards. Pardon my friend.
While Wong as the shopkeep is always trying to make a buck and keep the town going. Now, of course, this is Bacon and Ward's show. Jet Palance was actually supposed to be Earl in the early draft, but, you know, honestly, I'd love to see what that would look like in a weird universe. But they made the better choice here. Bacon and Ward have some of the best f***ing chemistry in film.
Pardon my French.
Honestly, I'd put them in the same league as Gibson and Glover, or Murphy and Nolte. Bacon has that youthful energy that is captivating. I mean, there's a screen presence here that cannot be denied. His bickering between who made breakfast.
The hell you did. Bologna and beans.
Yeah, the opening fake stampede. I mean, there is something here that can't just be replicated by switching out the actor. And shows a sort of minute level of acting, and honestly is the reason he's the star he is. But as I've grown older, I relate more to Earl. And find Fred Ward, the master at hand here.
I mean, are we asking too much of life?
I mean, his little expressions and how he emotes in every situation is brilliant. Yes, brilliant. Kevin Bacon may have the energy as Val, Michael Gross may steal the movie with his straight yet humorous portrayal as Bert, but listen up. Fred Ward carries every scene. Just watch him, trust me. And all this is built around a unique and grounded monster. One for the ages, the Graboid. Created by Alec Gillis and Tom Woodruff Jr. of Amalgamated Dynamics, Tremors delivers on the monster front with such precision that I put its design alongside classics like The Blob or The Xenomorph from Alien. I mean, this thing is a beauty, and it takes a level of skill and balls, brass balls to be specific, to take your monster and put it in such bright, direct light. There is no hiding it here. It is out in the forefront for all to see. And the best decision was showing the tongued creature first with a massive reveal later on. It's a fantastic design that has a realistic yet sort of out of this world look. And well, yeah, I'm about to be the old man that yells at cloud, but everything is practical. And so even being fake, it interacts with the dry desert world it's in. I am not there, but I feel this thing. I understand it. It makes sense. And that's the thing about practical effects. When even the best CGI comes around, I will f***ing take this worm, this Graboid, over anything in Avatar. This will always be better than anything created digitally.
That I love. I absolutely love.
Amalgamated Dynamics understood the assignment and created something that 30 plus years later holds up like the day it came out. It stands the test of time.
Goddamn bitch. Pardon my French.
The reason Tremors means so much to me is that it exemplifies a style of movie that doesn't really exist anymore. Not with this type of tone and backing. Tremors is an adventure movie with the flavor of Raiders of the Lost Ark, mixed with a 50s monster movie, scored with Ernest Troost's zestful Western harmonics and Robert Folk's darker sounds. Tremors is a movie that bucks the trends of the genre it's in. I mean, it's filmed mostly outside, in the warm sun. This is a monster flick that isn't going for the usual tropes. It's a story of friendship, community, guns, and cigarettes. And it never talks down or pokes fun of its own. There's a warmth and respect to this Western adventure that has always stuck with me. And yes, not everything from script to screen stayed the same. Characters were removed, situations altered and added. And we even get one of the rare times where a test screening changes something for the better. Because in the alternate ending, Val turns around to go back to Rhonda. But they needed to kiss, they absolutely needed to kiss, and I am 100% on board. Because there is something special when the music hits, he goes in for the kiss, and it dallies up. It is just an ending for the ages here, and cements this with that soulful feeling. Tremors is an absolute classic that is backed up with good writing, stylish directing, and a cast that breathes life into the smallest of characters. I miss these type of adventures, but to look on it this many years later brings me a deep joy. This will always exist. Tremors will never go away, but I was lucky enough to have it in my rotation in the formative years of my education of cinema. And I'll never take that for granted. Thank you to everybody involved for giving me one of the building blocks of my youth.
I'm gonna